I'm very happy to see you all again. It's been a pleasure to come and spend time with you and to share with you the benefits one gets if one is lucky to be found by a perfect living master. As I've said earlier, a perfect living master is an ordinary person like ourselves. He is born like us, dies like us, falls sick like us, eats his clothes, eats his food like us, wears clothes like us. No change in life. He is exactly like us. He is born with the same kind of prarabdh, same destiny like us, lives his life exactly according to his destiny like us. Therefore, the difference between a perfect living master and ourselves is simply in the knowledge he has, in the awareness he has. He has opened his inner eyes, he has opened his inner mind, he's opened his soul, he's opened his vision of the true home. By doing that, he is constantly aware of all levels of creation and the nature and truth about the Creator. He has not known by meditation at one time somewhere and has come to tell us. Once he knows all that, he knows all the time, 24/7. So even when we meet him in personal life, we are meeting somebody who the only difference between that person and ourselves is he is fully aware of everything which we are trying to gain by meditation, gain by various methods of journey, on spiritual journey to find out. He does not come here to teach anybody. There are lots of teachers, thousands of teachers in this world. Perfect living masters are very rare. According to great master, even in the Kali Yuga Iron Age, the number has not crossed the four fingers of the two handmaid, namely not more than 8. So that's a very small number for such a large population on a planet with so many seekers. But teachers come to teach us how to meditate. Masters, perfect living masters, do not come to teach us how to meditate. They come into our life when we are ready to go back home, to our true home. When we are ready, they appear. This arrangement was not made by them. This arrangement was made by our own souls, our own Atma.